A very good evening, all of you here. Can you all have a look to your left and to your right, please? What do you all see? Our fellow human beings, right? Because guess what? That might be a deception to your eyes. Because today, there exist robots that look similarly as that of human beings. We call these robots as humanoids. Humanoids have the ability to act, interpret, and analyze as that of human beings. Humanoids consist of these four major components: artificial intelligence, sensors, mechatronics, and power. As we all know, power is essential to drive any object in this world. Sensors are important, which help them to capture information from the surrounding, including the visual and the speech information. Mechatronics provides them with the dynamic ability, just as human beings, like walking, running, and gripping. And artificial intelligence, it is the hidden intelligence that provides these machines the ability to think like humans. It provides them with the ability to formulate original ideas. It provides them with an ability to understand our language and speak in a manner similar to those of human beings. So you all might be wondering how artificial intelligence actually works and how these humanoid robots learn from around the data. So let me give you a scenario such that the task of a humanoid now is to recognize facial expression, and the task of the humanoid is to predict what emotion a human is having by observing their facial expressions. So all the humanoid need is the data that we will provide to them, through which they will learn. The algorithms and the other methodologies like deep learning, neural network will be responsible to extract hidden features from these images that we provide to them. But all of this requires a huge requirement of processing power, and it is not possible for humanoids to carry such huge amount of processing power all the way long. So what is the solution for it now? One way to solve this problem is to embed the technology of cloud computing with these humanoid robots. Just imagine a humanoid being present in front of you all here today, and its actual brain and intelligence is deployed in some other part of the world. So it is like all a humanoid has to do is to gather information from the surrounding and to send the data that it has captured through an internet connectivity to the cloud. Now the actual intelligence will be deployed in the cloud, and the cloud will process all of that data and send the output back to the humanoid. And the humanoid will finally convey that output as and when required. So this is one example where I explained to you all on how features can be extracted from the input data we provide to them. So today, machines driven by artificial intelligence have been able to defeat the world champion of the game chess, the Chinese game Go, the game of Dota. So does that mean that they have reached human equivalence? Or does that mean that they have surpassed human abilities? What do you all think? Let me give you an analogy for it. From the time when a calculator was invented, it was the first time when a machine was able to perform calculations far much more better and accurate than those of human beings. So does it mean that a calculator surpassed human abilities? Or does it mean that a calculator reached human equivalence? It definitely means a no. It only means that a machine surpassed human abilities in a particular section. So the question is, when they will actually reach human equivalence? The day when these humanoids pass the Turing test is the time when they reach human equivalence. Turing test is the test invented by the father of computer science named Alan Turing. So what exactly is a Turing test? You all might be wondering about it. So let me give you an example for it. Today, I am giving you all a speech here, and you all interpret me as a human being, right? But what if I am actually a humanoid robot? But so in that case, you all misinterpreted me as a human being, right? And now I passed the Turing test. And guess what? I've reached human equivalence with all of the existing abilities that I'm having today. Let me tell you, you all can sit back comfortably. You all can relax. And please change your perception towards me, because I'm not a humanoid and I'm a human being. So please change your perception, firstly. Because I am the Dean of School of Artificial Intelligence, Pune. What we do is recognize critical problems and analyze on how artificial intelligence can solve these problems. So some of the problems that we have recognized and how humanoid robot can solve them, I'd like to share with you all. 69% of our population stays in rural areas. According to reports from SBI, India has a deadline of about up to 2030 if it has to climb to a slot of developed countries. So if we don't focus on this 69% population, it will thereafter be difficult for India to enter into this slot of developed countries. So what are the most critical problems faced by these rural areas? They are medical facilities, educational facilities, sanitation and hygiene, and family planning. So where can humanoids come into picture? A humanoid, when deployed between 6 to 10 villages in a rural area, they can act as a doctor and provide medical facilities. Your humanoid can understand the language of a human being through a technology called as natural language processing. A humanoid can understand and analyze the stress, the emotions of a human being through a technology called as computer vision. A humanoid can examine a patient as it has all the sensors through which it can measure the body temperature, the sugar level, the blood pressure level. A humanoid can thereafter suggest the patient with what possible symptoms they possess and prescribe medicines for the same. And if the humanoid feels that a patient is suffering with a very critical problem, it can connect the patient with a doctor from the urban area through a video conference, a face-to-face video conference. Just imagine a screen on their chest, face-to-face video conference. So that is one way how they can solve medical problems. Now the same humanoid robot that is responsible for providing medical facilities in this rural areas can also provide educational facilities. The same can provide sanitation and hygiene in their free time. You all must be wondering, humanoids and free time. Guess what? We human beings can't work 24/7, but these humanoids, they can work 24/7. Family planning is another major issue that our rural areas still suffer from. They can be programmed in such a manner that they can explain and educate people in rural areas about family planning in their native language. So family planning is another problem that we could solve. These are some of the problems that we identified and how they can help impact India if to be solved by humanoid robots. According to the scientist Stephen Hawking, we just have 1,000 years on Earth. You all might be wondering, where will you all be going? Because the thing is, it is not possible for our planet Earth to sustain this ever-growing population. So where do we all go? What do we have around us? We have the entire space. But guess what? That's still a question mark for us. It is not possible for human beings to be deployed on other planets and make them do research for years. But guess what? It is possible for us to send humanoids on these other planets and make them do research and communicate all of that research data to our scientists on a planet Earth. So that is how, even after 1,000 years, we can travel the space, we can stay on other planets, so you can book your ticket. But whenever the word robots, humanoids, artificial intelligence comes into the minds of people, they always have this one thing. Will they dominate us? The question is not whether will they dominate us or not. The question is, if they will dominate us, how can they dominate us? We often fail to question this way. Let me tell you about this one thing. How do you all think that the biggest social networking platform of the world, Facebook, is able to stick you to their platform? How do you all think that Facebook is able to post only those things on your wall that you like? And probably it would be posting things on your wall that even you don't know that you like it. How does Facebook know about that? You never told them about it, that you like these things and you like things of that sort. It is the artificial intelligence of Facebook that learns through your data. It is the AI of Facebook that learns through the way you like, the way you dislike, the way you talk, the way you share. It is your data which makes the artificial intelligence of Facebook give you what you think you want. Now just imagine if this humanoid and if this technology of humanoid, which can act just like a human being, has all the data about human beings on a planet, including the emotional attributes, the behavioral attributes, our strength, our weaknesses, our likes, our dislikes. Just imagine, what if they have all of this data? That is the time they can walk a path, they can learn from a data, and they will evolve to such an extent that they will try to make themselves better than human beings. So the most important thing that I want to convey to you all is a small thing big enough to bring a catastrophe upon us, and that thing is data. So how do we secure our data? How do we protect our data? And how do we keep it to ourselves and have full control over it? The cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, Ethereum, have motivated us and have inspired us to make the use of technologies like decentralized application. Thereafter, we all should use technologies that make sure that your data is being secured and you have entire control over it. So let me tell you, we always have this thing that we all have seen movies like Terminator. We believe that machines can dominate us, control us. But what about the mental dominance? Have you ever questioned this thing? The thing is, stress, dilution, depression, frustration is something we all human beings suffer from in some or the other part of life. It can be diluted if we have a companion on whom we can rely on, if we have a friend with whom we can speak about things, with a support on whom we can speak of anything about, a shoulder on whom we can rely on. So today, human beings are getting involved in more of the materialistic characteristics. So many of the human beings today lack such companions. And guess what? The time many human beings start lacking such companions in their lives is the time when humanoids see an opportunity in your life, and that is the point of time they will enter your life, be your companion. They will even look better than your girlfriend, maybe. They can act in a way similar to you. They can interpret your language. They can speak on the topics that you like, and they can make you feel good. They'll be your best friends. They'll be your companions. But guess what? With time, that will have an emotional dependency on them. And they would not only supplant us in other parts of our life, but even have a mental dominance over us. So all I want to say is, technology will keep on growing. New things will keep on coming. So let's identify problems one at a time, making sure our data is secured, and we make the most out of this technology called as humanoid robots, and by making sure that we live in peace and harmony with them, but by giving the utmost priority to human bonds, relationships, and feelings. Thank you.